photography is a process of capturing time. Reinventing that for our questions today is really the flesh of our work.
I'm doing computational and experimental approaches to studying dark matter, this mysterious substance that we are pretty confident exists out there in the universe, but we don't know exactly what it is.
My work tends to use materials and objects to think about what performance might be without the body. I understood in my own practice that cosmology played a big role on the human consciousness.
Ideas about time and what it means are really on the forefront of my mind, so I'm pretty naturally connected on a lot of things. Photography and film have had really a pivotal, important impact on the way we see time.
George and I ended up locating different sites where we could actually take our big ideas and put them somewhere concrete.
Yerkes Observatory has this beautiful, beautiful glass plate collection. Back in the day when they took these photos of the cosmos, of the stars, they wouldn't do them on film, instead they would do them on glass plates.
We happened upon the Bunyajido, which is a Korean star chart from the 14th century. To understand the concept of time through the revolutions of the night sky led us down a path of exploring how something like that even comes to happen. What we ended up with was a series of cyanotype images.
Cyanotype is a particular type of chemical emulsion that you can use to make exposures. You get these beautiful blue photos, and so we felt it would be really interesting to use these for nighttime photography.
Nighttime photography was a way to think about how do we track the time of the stars through its light. We challenged ourselves to work with materials and a process that neither one of us are technically experienced in. That challenge brings a level of empathy that helps drive some of these questions.
In science, you usually set up an experiment and you have a very good idea of how that's going to proceed and what you're going to get at the end, whereas in an artistic endeavor, it's sort of a different thing entirely. That was really interesting and beneficial to me to work through that process.
Slowing down and asking questions about time's elasticity is extremely important to understand what reveals itself when you're not moving at the speed of a hyper-capitalist environment. The kind of quiet resistance of that thought, I think, is showing up in our project, allowing ourselves to explore these experimental spaces and to appreciate the production that's happening along the way.